Alright, hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty and ArtCast 331, I'm pretty sure. I already painted this piece on an earlier ArtCast, but just finishing it up here. I just got back from lunch and I was looking through my email and I got a kind of a question type thing from a younger kid, and I just wanted to actually answer really quick just before I forgot, you know, and I put it off till I'm doing the next piece. I'll probably never get around to talking about it again. So anyway, the email's from this younger guy named Brent, and he's by younger I mean like 16. That's why I think this whole thing is so cool. And he was telling me that he had been selling his art on Etsy, and over the last year, let me look on my computer and just read it real quick. But yeah, over the last year he had been selling his art, just original art, on his Etsy store, and has made $2,400 in a year. And man, at like 16, I'm like super impressed, you know? That is awesome, dude. Anyway, the question is, it's like, I guess he watches my videos and he just wants to know, like, what else do you do? Like, how do you expand out from, you know, successfully selling your stuff on Etsy to, like, making a career out of it? I mean, you're only 16, so, I don't know. To me, like, you know, if you're 16 and you sell 2,000, by the time you're 20, you'll probably be selling 20,000, you know what I mean? It's just like, I think that, you know, you're totally on the right track and you're killing it, man. I wish I'd have been doing the same kind of thing. I mean, of course, Etsy and those kind of sites weren't around when I was, younger. Let's make sure I'm still painting on camera. But yeah, I could talk about that a little bit. And Etsy is like a great place to start. And I still have a store on Etsy, and it's basically my main store. For a while I had Store Envy, which kind of like integrated into my site. And before that I had a site that was just a standalone on my actual website. And if I was to give you like any advice, I would say that's probably the next step, because I took a look at your Etsy store. You're pretty much selling original art, and before that, I should say that the next step is probably prints, because then you're getting paid multiple times off of one piece. So and I've done prints like several different ways. I've had them where I print them off my computer. I've gotten print runs. And I'm not sure what the best is. I mean, if you've got a nice enough printer and can afford some nice paper and stuff, doing them off your own printer isn't a bad way to go. But you definitely want to, you know, get the archival inks and stuff, so you're not, you know, your prints aren't fading and stuff when they get to your customers. If you can't do that, some of these smaller printers, you know what I mean, like almost like postcard printers and stuff like that, can actually work for doing some nice prints. I've done that too, where I basically just buy like large postcards and have those as prints, like double-sided, and you know, on the back it'll be like the art of Jeff Lafferty, or not the art of Jeff Lafferty, but you know, Jeff Lafferty illustration. And then you don't have to be like doing them like one at a time and things like that. And of course, like, you know, my sketch cards, back when I did the sketch cards, those were printed off my computer, and then they were like glued down onto a board and like varnished, and you know, they were kind of more of a like a specialty type item that was like geared towards like sketch cards, you know, geared towards that sketch card market, and those guys are real specific about what they want. So there's definitely some different ways to do it, but you know, the thing about Prince is, I mean, it's basically passive income. It's not 100% passive, of course, because you have to ship. But it's like, you know, you can turn a piece that you sell for $50 into a piece that's basically worth like 2,000 by just selling prints, you know. That's the reality of it. So don't underestimate that. It's definitely worth like figuring out, and especially if you're already selling, you know, if you've already found like customers on a place like Etsy, people that want your art, because they're gonna come back and want your prints also. And that's, you know, that's the same for like doing a book eventually and all that kind of stuff. But that's what I would say, like, you know, if you want to just sort of like bring your income up a smidge, you know, that would totally do it. The second thing, you know, that I would kind of like recommend is actually setting up your own website. And I think that having your store on Etsy is totally fine, because I do it too. I feel like all you really need for a store is just a place to direct people. And, you know, you could do that on just a standalone type store on your site, or like a place like Etsy. The reason I kind of stopped with my like just my standalone type store, it was just, you know, like it wasn't even a store, it was just integrated into my website. So basically, when you would click, you know, you'd go to my gallery page. This is how it was set up back in the day. You go to my gallery page, and then there would be the piece, and then at the bottom of the piece it would say, you know, buy a print or something like that. And you'd click that button, and then it would just click to the next page where you could buy it, basically. So it would open up a page in the store that looked like my website that you could just buy the piece right there. And I think that's great. I think it works more for like, you know, those buyers that are used to buying from you. Whereas like Etsy can bring in some people from the outside, you know, and that's what's great about a place like Etsy or eBay or something, is because there's like customers looking around there, and so you get that discoverability also. And, you know, I definitely fell, you know, into the trap of having too much stuff, basically. So like, you know, I'd get a piece done and I'd go to sell it, I'd go to put the print up, and I would have, you know, my own store, I'd have Etsy, I'd have eBay, you know. And it just got to the point where it's like, there's too much listing time, too much internet time and stuff like that. So that's another reason why I just kind of pulled it back. And I'm like, well, Etsy's a good place to sell prints, everybody's used to going there, so why not just make that my full-time store. But here's the deal about like the website. Is because now that you're getting customers in a place like Etsy, they're like digging your stuff. And I'm sure you probably already run into it a little bit, which is like, once people start buying your work, they want like custom pieces. They want their own, you know, idea of whatever you're doing. And if you're into doing commissions, I'm not quite sure, you know, if you are or not, but, you know, when you have like, you know, you're a place to direct people, and like a page on your website where it just makes it very like easy to hire you, and, you know, maybe even explains like the whole process. Or you know, I have, you know, if you go to my website and look at, you know, the way I have it set up, I don't think I have, it doesn't say hire me, but I think it says commission original art. And then there's like options, you know. One will be like, I mean, I know I have one in there for like book covers, even though I don't get many of those. I was kind of just I set that up thinking that, you know, maybe I could develop that market, and it just never really happened. But I have one for like sketch cover com you know, sketch the sketch cover comics, you know, the comics with a blank cover. And it just kind of explains that, you know what I mean? It explains that, you know, it's like a blank comic, and you know, I draw a picture on it, and this is the prices, and this is usually how long it takes, and this is if I do a sketch or not, you know. And there's just the same thing for commissions. It just makes it real, like, upfront and easy for people to kind of look at that and go like, oh, okay, I know what to expect from this guy. And it just makes you, like, easy to hire, you know. And that's like a really good thing, and that would further, like, you know, develop your market, you know, if you can get into, like, doing commissions. I think the thing about, like, a website is it's like a place to, you know, how do I describe it? Like, when I started doing sketch cards a long time ago, I was, like, really, you know, like, adamant about, like, setting up a site and you know, making that, like, sort of, like, the hub and the place where you would go if you want, like, Jeff Lafferty Art. So if you want prints, you go to my site. If you want, you know, commissions, you go to my site. Anything to do with me, you go to my site. And, you know, like, especially back then with a lot of the sketch card guys, you know, they didn't have websites, or their websites weren't, like, developed, you know. It was, like, really like an eBay type thing back then. Everybody would sell on eBay, and, like, there was just no way to kind of follow those people. And I still kind of see that a little bit today. I don't pay as much attention to the sketch card market like I used to. But I think that they were, you know, kind of doing a little bit of a disservice to themselves, because I would pay attention to them because I was paying attention to the market. But, you know, I noticed that it was, you know, it was hard to follow those people, even though, you know, you could follow their eBay store and things like that. But it just was hard to catch all of it. And I think, like, nowadays, you know, with things like Facebook and all that, you know, there's so many sites that, you know, limit the stuff that goes out, you know what I mean? It's like YouTube, you know, you push the subscribe button, but you're not actually subscribed, and you're not going to get the updates until you click that little check mark that says, you know, get updates or whatever like that. So, and like Facebook is the same way, where it's like, you know, you follow somebody or whatever like that, but then you don't get all the stuff. You only get, you know, what Facebook thinks you want to see. So if you haven't been around there lately, you start to totally miss, you know, what people are doing. I notice that, you know, just all the time on Facebook. People I you know, pay attention to and care about what they're doing just don't even, you know, don't even show up in my feed. And that's why it's good to, you know, have a place, you know, a place to drive people. And I think your site can be like a Tumblr site or something. It doesn't have to be like a standalone website. I mean, you could go to like Squarespace or something and do that, or you could like set one up like mine on like Blogger, or set one like up on like Tumblr or whatever. But a site is, you know, it's good because it's like your store on the internet, you know what I mean? And nobody's gonna find it by themselves. Nobody's gonna, you know, I mean, it's worthless as far as like promotion goes, but what it is it's like a place to like round up your existing like fans, you know what I mean? Is like they know they can find you there. So if they lose track of you at some point and they think, oh, you know who would be perfect for this? I mean, that's a good example actually, because a little while ago I did a sketch card of Indiana Jones like holding the cup from like, you know, Last Crusade. And that guy that wanted that thing was, I mean, he was from, like, when I used to do sketch cards like crazy. And, like, that sketch card was, like, a special deal because it was one that was, like, signed by Harrison Ford. And he just wanted something, like, really cool on the other side of it. And, you know, he thought of me. If I wouldn't have had a website and all I was, you know, all I was like, you know, maybe a Facebook page or even just a store on eBay or something, it's like he would have a heck of a lot harder time finding me by just, you know, going on to search Jeff Lafferty. I mean, other people sell, you know, my art on there because I've sold so much. Some people resell it sometimes. It's just a ton harder to find me. So to me, like, a website is like imperative, you know. It's not like it was back in the day when I used to have like a ton of traffic on my site and all this kind of stuff. But it still does its job, which is to just, you know, sell art to like my existing customers, you know, and keep them up to date on what I'm doing. So anyway, I guess that's it. Like I said, it's just a short one today. And I just kind of wanted to throw all that kind of stuff out. And I think that, like, you're doing great, man. Just keep it up. I mean, I wish I was this ambitious when I was, like, 16. You know, that's, like, awesome. And, yeah, good luck with it. And see everybody next time. Don't forget, Patreon. Check me out on Patreon if you're into the videos and all that kind of stuff and helping me make more videos, make more art, and that kind of thing. So see you guys later.